When selecting the components for our NITRA compact modular valves, we need to first understand the required communications and air pressures. Let's start on the left side of the system. There are several different left supply exhaust end plates, and determining communications to the valve configuration and system pressures will help determine which plate to choose. Let's discuss communications first. Will this be hardwired using the 25-pin D-sub, or will this be connected and communicated with Ethernet IP? If choosing Ethernet IP, there are much less wires to deal with. The system must have an Ethernet control device like a PLC to control the valves. We have several how-to videos on connecting these Ethernet IP modules to our Automation Direct PLCs. The Ethernet IP modules can be daisy-chained by using one of our cables like this model. Automation Direct offers M12 Ethernet cables in several lengths with straight and 90-degree connectors. The number of Ethernet modules daisy-chained are limited by the number of IP addresses in a subnet. Don't forget to grab one of the communication Ethernet cables and power cables for the Ethernet modules. This cable connects from the control device to the first module on the communication drop. Selecting the D-sub connector style requires the connection of wires to the plate for each valve. While the plate is less money, the connection can be more labor-intensive. After we've selected our communications on the left-hand modular plate, let's discuss system pressures. For example, if we selected the Ethernet IP communications, there are still two end plates to choose from, one push-to-connect or two push-to-connect fittings. What is the difference? If we want all valves to operate with a pressure between 45 and 100 PSI, we should select the CMV-E1X-4X with one push-to-connect fitting. If we need to operate valves either at vacuum to 45 PSI or 100 to 145 PSI, then we should choose the CMV-E2X-4X with two inlet ports. This module will allow two valve inlet pressures, vacuum to 145 PSI, at ports 1 and 11, but also require a 45 to 100 PSI pilot supply connected to port X. If the system requires high airflow, there are several options to supply more inlet and exhaust connections to the modular valve assembly. We can simply add a CMV-C3X-5X right end plate. Air supply or vacuum to 145 PSI must be connected to both ports 1 and 11. There is also an exhaust port on this end plate. We can add an intermediate module. The CMV-D1X-3X adds an inlet at port 4 that will connect to the inlets of all valves in the assembly. Port 2 is an extra exhaust port that connects to all valves. This module can be added anywhere in the middle of the system. The CMV-D2X-3X is a way to change the supply pressure to only the valves to the right of this module. It blocks the main inlet pressure coming from the left side and allows a new supply to feed any valves installed to its right. Be sure to connect both ports 2 and 4 to supply. The last intermediate module, the CMV-D3X-3X, is simply an additional exhaust port for valves installed to its right. These give the system an additional exhaust when the exhaust air needs to be released more quickly. To build out the rest of the CMV system, we simply select the solenoids needed. When adding valves to the assembly, it is important to count solenoids when figuring system capacity. Each modular assembly can support up to 16 solenoids. Many of the individual valve units have two solenoids. All of the CMV model three-way valves are doubled up in a valve unit to save space. This means that each three-way valve unit has two independent valves, but it also means that each three-way unit has two solenoids. These double three-way units are available with two normally closed, two normally opened, or one normally closed and one normally opened valves. With so many options in our CMV series, you'll save time, space, and money. Optional accessories include DIN rail mounting brackets and replacement screws and gaskets. Don't forget, we sell pneumatic fittings, tubing, air cylinders, pressure sensors, and more. If you have any questions about using Automation Direct's NITRA pneumatics, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning support team during regular business hours. They will be happy to help. Click on this short video to learn more about Automation Direct support options, and click here to learn more or see more videos on the NITRA products. And be sure to click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be notified of new videos. And don't forget to hit the like button below.